And now, your hosts for Oklahoma football, head coach Barry Switzer and Steve Davis.
And welcome, everyone, to Oklahoma football. Saturday night, the University of Oklahoma Sooners defeated the Colorado Buffaloes 24-6 in Norman. Coach, it wasn't all that pretty, but you can roller skate in a buffalo herd.
No, you stole that from back in 1972 when we lost to Colorado in the rain up there in Greg Pruitt's days. It was a tough ball game. It was a physical football game. They nearly played a perfect ball game. They only had one turnover in the ball game and only had three penalties. And they never stopped themselves, so we had to stop them. Our defense had to play well, and we did. They only had two drives in the ball game. They got one scoring opportunity, and we gave them the ball at the 20, and they got a field goal. And your defense, anytime they get that type of field position on you, all you can hope for, if they're not going to turn the ball over to you, is force a field goal. And our defense played well enough to force that. Then they took one drive to get a field goal. Then they had another short drive in the ballgame. And other than that, they never moved the football. The second half, we completely dominated them. Offensively, we obviously made a lot of mistakes and had six penalties. Couple of key penalties that really hurt us. You start out first and 25 and first and 20 a couple of times. That eliminates, against any type of defensive football team, that eliminates converting and forces another punting situation. We fumbled nine times, lost three, and of course two of them we were going to score. We had great field position. We start off the ball game, look like we're going to take the first drive and go score, as we'll see on the playback here, but we turn it over.
Well, we'll see about those turnovers, and we'll see the first quarter action after these commercial messages. The first night game at the University of Oklahoma Sooners in Owen Field. Beautiful weather last night, Coach. Did you like playing at night?
Well, I'd rather play in the day. It's too long. It makes the day too long, Steve. It just drags on, and it was pretty. I've always thought night games were, it's a great atmosphere to play in. We won the toss. We deferred. Elected to defend the north goal and kick off of the wind. We didn't kick the ball very deep. Kicked about the goal line, and they get a return to about the 24-yard line. So Colorado's first possession, they start out unbalanced, run a counter play. They got some good backs, quick backs. That's Behemini, a freshman out of California, carries on the counter play. Unbalanced line again, they hand it to the fullback. Quick, tough runner up inside, makes a few yards. Fullback again, first down. Gets first down. It's unbalanced line. Again, Darren Kilpatrick makes the play from backside for about a one-yard gain. So it's second and nine now, Steve. An option. Leap over the top right there. It was a great play. But Dante Williams, he got hurt, an ankle injury in this game, and he'll probably be out a week or so. Tight end in the boundary. We'll try to run the option and pitch the ball in great speed here. This back, J.J. Flanagan, has really got great speed, and I think that he's also out of California. They have to punt the football in a third down situation. Defense handled that possession, and we've got good field position here. That's not bad. We deferred, and we kicked off, so now we start out at the 33-yard line. We hand the ball to Lydell Carr. Lydell had three fumbles in the ballgame, but I tell you what, he really ran tough. He was really physical, tough in the ballgame. Trap option, pitch the ball to Patrick Collins, first down. Picks up 10 yards before he steps out of bounds. First and 10, about an 8 or 9 yard run.
Ball at the Oklahoma 45.
Left hash mark, and look at Lydell ricochet up through here. First possession, now there goes the ball, fumble. That started off the night tempo. We've got the ball going in. We're in four down zone right now, and we've got the ball at their 35-yard line. Third play of the game. So they get a big break. We got some momentum going here. Our first possession, Lydell Carr, great tough running up inside, good cut, red option, keyed the ball, good blocking. Anthony Phillips knocking him back. Here's Keith Jackson downfield. Guy knocks the ball out, reaches around him and puts his hand on the ball, and really great run by Lydell.
I see a lot of players wearing gloves. Does that have any effect?
No, well, nearly every football team in America wears them, so it gives them a tacky grip. Mm-hmm. Receivers like it. Pitch the ball on the option play. They're going to throw the ball, halfback pass, and throw it out of bounds. Second possession, they have the ball. O.C. Oliver in the flat. Unbalanced line here again. They're going to throw the curl, and the ball is batted down.
Of course, it's Colorado punt. It'll be fourth and eight. Colorado 38, and they're punting.
Charles Thompson, Bernard Hall deep. Here's Charles Thompson, second team quarterback. Just protect the ball, Charlie. So we start out the 20 now. Our second possession of the ball game, 20-yard line. Trap option. We fumble the ball, and Patrick falls on it right there. We lose a yard. Didn't execute and block the play well right there. So we come up here, trap option, pitch the ball. Stafford inside, makes about 6 or 7 yards. It's a good run there.
Third down and six.
We hand the ball to Rodney Anderson, and he gets about 5 yards here. We come up, what?
2 yards short.
2 yards short. It's fourth and two. So that lost yardage play on our second possession keeps us from controlling the ball. So we punt the ball. We don't punt it very good with the wind. And they get the ball at the 38-yard line. They run the fullback for about a yard gain. The guy's a pretty tough runner. Only made 49 yards all night long on about 20 carries. McKissick, counter play again. They got some quickness in their back. Good defense. Picks up a few yards. About third and five, option play. Salonese, good defense. Reed, Dante Jones. Got to punt it again. Can't move the ball against our defense, but the field position game. We stopped ourselves the first time with a fumble. The second possession, we don't have good field position again at the 19-yard line. Good coverage by Colorado, good effort. There's Lydell, good tough run, way to run, Lydell. First down, we bring the ball up to the 41-yard line.
Gains 9, second and 1, Oklahoma 42-yard line.
Second and 1. And right here, we snap the ball to center. We make the first down, but they could have called us for motion right there.
Center what
snapped
happened?
Well, center snapped the ball prematurely. Jamail, good cut. People jump up in your face on the trap option. He's always supposed to duck up inside, and he did it. Real quick flank for 5 yards. Counter play, no gain. Jamail, trap option. Great run to Jamail. Putting speed down the boundary. About a 25-yard run, 28-yard run. First and 10. There's Patrick Collins, little Patrick. Great little blocker. Great finesse player. Jamail on the option. Great slow camera work here. Out of bounds. Got the first down. Too tight. Hand the ball off to Lydell Carr. Moving the ball. They haven't slowed us down yet. First drive, we had that one fumble. We lost yardage fumble. Lydell for, I think, the first down.
That brings up third and two.
Third and two. Pitch the ball. Touchdown Sooners. Great block by Collins. Great speed down the boundary. Stafford touchdown. Big man. Watch it again. Watch Patrick Collins come through here. Great block by Keith Jackson right there. Watch a little Patrick cut the safety down right there. Super job. And Stafford's got the great speed. And the Sooners score first. R.D. Lasher adds it, and 7-0. First quarter. Field was a little wet. We had some rain, a little drizzle the day before, and that some that day. Kick off again. Don't hit the ball very good with the wind right here.
Colorado will take over there. First and 10 at the 29-yard line.
And the ball, trap play, trap off. See the speed that they got at halfback now? Ricky Dixon is too much. The longest run they had right there.
13-yard gain.
And the ball to fullback. Motion. Fouling. Oh. We get it right there. Great job, Lonnie Finch, coming back. That's the only fumble they had in the ball game. Only turnover they had. He has a problem pitching to his right here. Fake the trap. Oh. Get it, Finch. Nightmare. Uh-oh, Jamail Holloway again. First down, 13-yard run. Jamail had 146 yards rushing this game. Tough game, got a cut. He got stitches in his fingers. We had to put stitches in his hand this morning. He got a bad cut on his left hand. Good job of blocking there, Patrick Collins. Carl Cabanis, first down Sooners.
Oklahoma has ball now, first and 10, Colorado 32.
Ball Lydell Carr, penalty this play. Got the ball at the 20-yard line. You don't think penalties don't come at critical times and stop your drive? We get a holding penalty. And I've looked at it on film, it was a ridiculous call. So now we're back at our 35. Instead of ball 20, and we fumble it.
Well, that previous play was a 9-yard gain with a 10-yard penalty.
So in that right here, we had to scramble here. He couldn't see Keith, the fullback, back then to him. We don't have the penalty. We got the ball at the 20 going to score, maybe 14-0 now. But now Jamail back on the quarterback draw. Picks up a few yards. Punt the football away now. Or kick the field goal. So we get the score out of it anyway. It's a good kick. Bardi last year through the uprights. So it's a 10-0 ball game. But we should have had a 14-0 ball game right here.
You've had a lot of opportunities.
Well, we have the third possession. We take the ball and go to 20. We have the penalty right there.
Quarter action. Oklahoma's kicking off after the field goal.
Kick it into the wind. We scored our field goal with no time remaining on the clock. They're 10-0 lead, and they get a kick return at about the 33-yard line, having to kick the ball into the wind. First possession, they run the fullback for no gain. Dante Jones in the middle of our front, Scott Evans in motion, going to throw the football. Throws over, we nearly iced the ball. Lonnie Finch nearly intercepted it. Streak right throughout to Campbell, the split receiver. Wishbone tight end left, run the fullback, pitch the ball in the option. And O.C. Oliver gets a few yards. They're going to have to punt the football to us. Can't make a first down against their defense, and they kick the ball away, and this is our fourth possession of ball game. Slip down here on the wet field. They come in a late hit and get knocked over. We get start out first and 10 here. We run a tight end reverse. Keith Jackson, we make 9 yards. Now we're going to fumble the football to him. This is our fourth possession now in the ball game. Had three the first quarter.
Okay, we don't have a replay of this, Coach, so we got to watch the first time coming up.
We run Keith on reverse right here. We get, that's good job, Greg Johnson. Good job, Anthony Phillips. 9-yard gain, 8-yard gain.
I meant a replay of the fumble. Here we go.
Hand the ball to Lydell. We fumble right here. They fall on it, and they've got the ball at our, 31-yard line here.
What happened? Did he just
fumble the football? Part of football. It will always be a part of football, but I don't like it happening to my team.
Did he get it knocked away from him, or just, no, just cough it up?
We got the first down, but fumbled on the first and 10 there. So now they got great field position. And Anisi, their quarterback, picks up a few, unbalanced to the left. They run the option play, and he jumps up in there for a first, I believe, right here. Ricky Dixon, a few of our people make the stop, linebackers. First down.
No, this fourth down play.
Fourth down, they sneak for first. It was third and one. And they, I think they give him a spot. They let him get the first on the spot. They're going to throw the football, first and 10. And they complete it for a 5-yard gain. They only completed 4 passes in the ball game for a total of 50 yards. Run a counter play to Behemini. A little short halfback from California. Picks a few yards. And the ball, I run the option play again for a few yards.
Brings up third down and 2 at the Oklahoma 3-yard line.
3-yard line. Hand the ball off to him and it. No goal. Good play, Dante Jones, defense. So it's 4th and 2. They've got to make the field goal, kick the field goal now. 4th and 2. Kick the field goal. They get 3 points by our turnover at the 20-yard line or at the 30, and when we make a first down. So we give them one.
Does that tell you something when they go for a field goal at that point, or is it just one of those points that you feel like they had to get points?
They do something later on that tells you you have to get points. They go on there in the field in the fourth down play they don't make. Stafford returns, gets a few yards. I think we have, we're at the 18-yard line here. Hand the ball to Rodney Anderson, the fullback, for 5 yards. We're at the 21, 22, 2nd and 7. And the ball to Patrick Collins on power play. I think we get close to first here.
Third down and one.
Third and one. This is one we mess up on. Wrong read, misread, and we take a loss and we have to punt the football. Didn't execute that play right there. We punt the football away on third and one. We didn't make it. We get a kick that gets a good roll, but still pretty good field position for them. So they take a drive here. This is really the only drive of the ball game they have in three down zone. Jumps up inside, makes a few yards, 8 or 9 yards. Second two. I think you get a first right here. Fullback.
Drive started on the Colorado 37. Now they're first and 10 at the 49.
There's a lot of broken set right now. Throw, they thought it completed it, but he didn't. The ball hit the ground. Officials saw it, and we could see it from our side of the field. He tried to act it in. Trying to be an actor. I think you can see it right here. Ball's on the ground. Bounces that back up to him.
He's obvious, pretty good, right? Pretty good actor.
The referee behind him, he thought maybe he fooled him, but you could see it from this side of the field. The officials could see it. And the ball of fullback, that's too much, 7 yards. That's his longest run of the game right there. The longest run he had was seven. Bootleg on the critical down, third down. He's got good quickness and picks up a first. Anesi, California. And the ball of fullback again for a few yards. Wrap him up, Dante Jones. Well, he's
second
a good player.
Seven at the OU 33.
Help him out, lineman. A little quickness. Out of J.J. Flanagan. Wing set. They hold Reed right there. I'm telling you what, they tackled Reed on the end. I don't how you can miss seeing those holding penalties. You got people on both sides of the line of scrimmage. They ought to be looking to tight end in the wing back set. Maybe the officials don't understand that those guys there are put there for a reason to block down on those ends. Grab hold of him. Right. He's holding, look at it. Reed, see, that's what happens. Someone holds you, grabs you, and you retaliate, and the official sees the retaliation, and you never see the penalty. Dante Jones, good play, Dante Jones. Look, the play's already over, and that little guy's grabbed hold of the wrong man. Gonna throw the football now. We'll have to scramble. Kurt missed the tackle. We get there. Darrell Reed gets him from behind. We lose those guys, Dante Jones, Reed, and Troy Johnson. We're going to really lose some good players. They are really good football players, make a lot of plays. They're going to try to throw the football, fake the fullback, out of wing set. They're going to try to throw the wing down the bounty. There's Kurt Casper making him scramble and misses the tackle. There's Darrell Reed from behind making the play. Got to kick at a field goal. Good job. Make them kick the field goal, and it's good. They had one drive. They moved for 20 yards and hit the field goal in a short punt.
How are you feeling right now at this point in the game,
Coach? We're not playing very good. We've given them a turnover, and we haven't had good field position. They kicked the ball deep. We're going to start out at 20-yard line right now. Pitch the ball to Patrick Collins. Picks up 4 yards, second and six on the option play. When we run the fullback, we've moved the ball at him. We take a loss here. Busted assignment. And we take a loss. You can't have that happen because now you're in a situation where you're going to have to throw the football. And we're going to try something here. Patrick was going to throw the ball in the lateral screen, but Patrick makes a great run out of it. His quickness and speed. We come up. We're going to throw the football here. Jamail, super job of throwing the ball. Carl Cadmus, good catch, first down. So we overcame those bad mistakes right there. So we got the ball at the 50-yard line. Keith Jackson, look at here. Look here, we're only a minute to go in the game. We got a first down at their 40-yard line. Now, isn't that stupid? Lose your poise. The guy grabs him, pulls him out of bounds, and Keith retaliates. They're going to call it on Keith. And he gets another penalty here just because he's frustrated and loses his poise. We lose field position. We got a chance to go score here, but we have a 15-yard penalty, unsportsmanlike contact on him. Now we hit Keith in the hands, and he dropped that ball. It didn't short right there, but he dropped the football, and he's frustrated. Someone says something to him, so he makes a move at him like that, and official calls that. That little gesture there cost us 15 more yards. You know, you need to have some judgment in the ballgame. I know the kid's wrong, but him, but I guarantee you, the nose guard said something to him to make him do that. Mm-hmm. Mouthing off. He was mouthing off all night long. Mm-hmm. And that's what you see him make a move with his hand. Wasn't that Rangers? Didn't even touch him.
Yep.
Didn't even touch him, but made a gesture of motion to him. Fumbled football. Take a 3-yard loss on the fumble pitch. We got to punt the football. Had a chance with a field position to go score a field goal or a touchdown and give them the ball. Well, the defense swarms them here. Gets after them good, and they can't move the football. And they're going to have to kick a long field goal. Our short punt return. 10-6. Halftime.
Coach, at halftime Saturday night, what are the things you're focusing in on with the team?
Well, first of all, we can't lose our confidence. We're the better team. We're not playing like we should play, and we know we can play. I think you become frustrated and you lose your confidence. I think that things that happen during a football game have to be displaced or put out of your mind when they do occur. You have to make them history because you can't dwell on it. And that's a very difficult thing. It's difficult for coaches and it's difficult for players to remove that. What's beating you. And I know it's, especially for Lydell Carr, we don't have another guy that is probably as tough and as physical and a great competitor and been a great player for 4 years than he does. He's giving great effort. And you'll see him the second half when we come back out on the football field. We give you one of those typical Oklahoma scoring drive, 22 seconds to go score a touchdown to start the second half. It is our opportunity to take the football, so we know that we're going to have to go score with it. We're going to have to go into the win. We've been making some miscues. That have created our offense to have poor field position, and we've overcome some of them because of our ability and talent and quickness and speed. But at the same time, we're not playing with consistency, and that is the key on offense. It's so much easier to play defense. You count on your defense to play the same way week after week after week. You can do that consistently. Offensively, you cannot go play and perform the same way game after game after game because the things that happen to offense, you don't have fumbles on defense. You do on offense. And you don't throw interceptions on offense. I mean defense. You do on offense. So what happens? Offense creates. There gives you so many more opportunities to not be successful because you've got to protect the football. And if we do that, we're going to be all right. But if we don't do that, we're like any other football team. You can have problems and get beat.
Statistically, 5 fumbles, lost 2, 3 penalties for 40 yards.
9 fumbles. We lost 3 fumbles, and of course.
But at halftime.
But at halftime, right. You're exactly right at halftime. So that concerns you, especially when you haven't turned the ball over the last 2 ball games. We didn't fumble against Texas, and we didn't fumble last week. So all of a sudden, you've had 5 the first half. You know we're concerned.
We'll be back with second half action after these messages. Second half, things began to look a little bit better, Coach.
We received the ball. We're going to the wind. They kick a short kick. 5, and here was a great run to Stafford, ricochets, they grabbed the face mask, penalty there. Now they get hit right there, spearing out of bounds, and they better call that. That guy better give that flag out. And we get the ball start out here, Jamail Holloway, option, jumped inside, up the field, Jamail, good job, Cabinus. Jamail, 28 yards down the boundary. First play. Here it again, replay. Great job of blocking offensive line. Great job of blocking Patrick Collins. Stafford, Jamail on the corner, outside. That's where you want to start it off second half right there. Flowed down the field. Lydell Carr, ricochet romance. Break tackles. Didn't take long. To block them line, knock them out of there. Big Lydell, great cut, tackling at the ball, grabbing the ball. Lydell Carr, senior fullback, 6'2", 225 from Enid, Oklahoma. Marty Lasher, extra point, 17-6.
A two-play drive, 22 seconds into the third quarter, and Oklahoma leads 17-6 over Colorado.
Sooner, Schooner. Kick off into the wind. Ball hits the ground, bounces, and they get a run back here. Just when we don't need a run back. Missed tackles right there. And they get a ball back near the 45. Great field position. Gets in the four down territory. Now they start the wishbone, pitch the ball in the option play, bounces outside of his feet. Good support, Lonnie Finch, Dylan, and two wishbone teams eat up the clock, Steve, as you know. Mm-hmm. No one puts the ball in the air and the clock runs down. There's not much time to do anything with it. You better make every possession count when you get it. There's Salonese, turns up for a few yards. Get close to first, wing formation, pure option. He's got the speed right there, turn up, make the play. Nearly tackled from behind, but he had the type of speed that he did the same thing that Jamail Holloway does to people. A pitch the ball and a halfback pass. Throws it in the ground. I believe they're gonna give it to him. And mark it a 4-yard gain, second and six. And the ball in a power play. Not much yards. Not much. They've got the ball in our end of the field because of kickoff return, 45-yard line.
Colorado's ball, first and 10 at the Oklahoma 22.
Try to run the option. Good speed there to Dylan. Get out there. Good play. Tony Woods. Tony Woods in for, he's from Colorado himself. He's in for a good cut to the back here, O.C. Oliver. They got better backs than he used to have. Dante Jones, boy, that's a great play right there. Tony Woods, fourth down play. That's fourth down, and what was it, Coach? I think it's fourth down, wasn't it?
No, that was the... Here's fourth down play.
Here's fourth down, right there. Hits the ball. Oh, a great defense.
Let's see a replay of this one.
Defense stops and we take it over. See, they didn't kick field goals. They got to make the decision to go. There's good play, Tony Woods. Dante Jones, good play right there, killer. They pitch the ball, and we've got a bunch of red shirts around him. There's a late hit, 63 coming in. That's ridiculous not to call that. I'm telling you, there's a bunch of, neither team played good in sportsmanship in this ball game. Because they both got the mouth, a great job of running, Jamail Holloway.
13-yard gain by Jamail Holloway.
Cheap shots made. Nothing there on the trap play, the fullback.
A lot of pushing and shoving, Coach.
Yep. Jamail Holloway, option, turn up, Jamail. Make the first. Punt the football. Punt the football away. Nothing on the trap play a minute ago. The fullback probably kept us from converting here. Punt the ball to the 30. We tack them at 35. Good job, Greg. But no, I tell you what, do we take the ball away? I don't know if he's already
down. We have a replay.
Do we have a replay of this?
No, we don't.
We don't. He thought he took the ball away from him when he was running.
Colorado's ball, first and 10, the Oklahoma 36. See you.
Pretty good field position for him. Now, that was incomplete again. Guys, not trying to act it out this time. Hand the ball to fullback, about three. Tony Woods, Dante Williams with an ankle injury. Salonese can scramble, but we get to him. Way to go. As Tony Woods makes another play. Big 99. Like 6'5", 280. Kick the ball away. Charles Thompson. Trying to get him on open field. Check the ball, Charles. Way to go. Good coverage for Colorado special team. Lydell Carr for about three or four. Jamail Holloway for a couple.
Be third down and five at the Oklahoma 25-yard line.
Patrick Collins. Way to go, Pat. Good throw. Jamail, strike. Patrick Collins. 28 yards. Little Pat. Guy hit Clubney across the face. We didn't get a penalty on that. You see this in replay again?
Yes, sir.
I tell you what, It's obvious. There's 75,000 heads. That's 150,000 eyeballs. You know, watch it. They see how he's tackled. Watch the guy club him right across the face mask here. Come in, right. Boom. Think you grab it. You're not supposed to do that. That's a penalty. I guess officials are looking at stands. I saw it, and everybody else did, too.
Second down and 10. The ball to Colorado, 47.
Took a shot, and first and 10. I want you to know it's first and 10, Steve. We took a shot, tried to throw the pass. So now it's second down, 11. Run the option play, and boy, Stafford fights his way for a few-yard gain. It's third and 7 now. So we got to throw again. We're in a situation where we can't convert. We should have probably ran the football. Lydell Carr gets the first down anyway. That's against what we thought it'd be given to that guy all the time anyway.
12-yard gain. Great run by Lydell Carr.
So we overcome. We fumble the football. Jamel fumbles the snap, and we take a lost fumble. This fumble, even though we didn't lose it, it's a lost yardage fumble. It kills the series. Difficult to convert, maintain the ball.
Third down and 15 now.
Jamel Holloway, boy, you think he isn't a heck of a player. Looking close to first down. Gets the ball right here. Fourth and one, we don't make this right here. Probably should have ran the fullback the option. Thought we'd sneak with Jamel. We don't get it, so we lose the ball. Jamel makes a great play, and instead of kicking the field, we didn't want to kick the field goal there. We were close enough to kick the field goal. We wanted to put a touchdown on the board. Going fourth and one, don't make it.
We pick up fourth quarter action. Oklahoma first and 10 at the Oklahoma 36.
Fourth quarter. Pretty field, lit up under lights. First game that ever been played under the lights, Norman. Ball at the 35-yard line, and the ball to fullback Lydell Carr, and the option read. Tackle took the quarterback. Jamel Holloway hands the ball to fullback Lydell again, a few yards. That option play. Jamel Holloway jumps up inside. Keith Jackson, good block. First down, Oklahoma. Jamel Holloway reverses the field, picks up about 7 or 8. Third and 2. Let's take a shot deep. Keith Jackson. They push Keith behind. You see that? See that cornerback? We see it in replay again. Don't see it again. Lydell Carr for about 5. So now it's 3rd and 5. Hand the ball to Lydell again to the 40. I was wrong with down distance there. Lydell, Jamel Holloway, option play. Getting close to first.
This will be 3rd down and 3. The ball at the Colorado 33-yard line.
3rd and 3. Fumble the football. We got it back, I think. I hope.
Yes, you did.
Lydell, we fumbled that one. And they got it. Can't score with it. We got the ball at our end of the field now, moving in. We fumble the football. Lose a scoring opportunity there. We're in 4-down zone. Lose the ball there.
Got Hatcher in the ball game.
Hatcher's in the ball game. I don't know why they went with Hatcher, but our guys go play him pretty good. Got after him right there, covered him.
He is the better passer.
No question. They feel like they're going to have something to pass the game. That's why they put him in. Looks like one of our backs. There he shows he's a better passer right there. Throws and drills and out routes. Good play. Good throw.
12-yard gain, but it's not enough. Colorado, fourth down.
Fourth down. Don't make it. I don't think. Better not.
They didn't this time. They didn't last Saturday, and they didn't this time.
Okay, we have the ball now. We fumbled the ball to them there anyway. Patrick Collins. Counterplay. Score, Pat.
what's your offensive line?
Okay. Hit replay. Pull the right guard and right tackle. Up through the hole, Greg Johnson. Good job, Greg. Keith Jackson blocked. There he is. Big guys leading him up through the hole. Juking Pat. Ball to 16. Good job, Jamel. Jamel got a penalty. Ball, Jamel hurdles to the 6, and they throw a flag. Now we'll look where Pennell dives back to the 18-yard line. Another counter play. Stafford won't make much here. Same play we ran to go Collins.
Now second and 15 to Colorado 21.
15. Quarterback draw. Jamel Holloway. Get out of his way. Takes the ball to inside the 10. This is option right halfback went the wrong way. He falls to about the, what is it, fourth and one.
Fourth down and one.
Fourth and one. Boy, that's a good job of running there. Great job fighting. Make that first. Rodney Anderson. Good block for Keith Jackson. Short again replay right here.
There's Keith. Two tight end set.
Too tight. He gets up right here. Help drive him back to get him the first down.
First and goal.
Patrick Collins picks the ball. He can get around him. Pat looked like he scored. They said he stepped out of bounds. Patrick. That's down there, though. Took a while to get that thing done. Fumbled the last time we were down there. One on fourth and one, didn't get it. Last time before that. We could have easily had two more in this ballgame.
Patrick Collins jumps into the end zone. Oklahoma wins the football game 24-6. The first night game is in the history books now as Oklahoma beats Colorado under the lights. The lights really didn't come on as brightly as maybe you thought they possibly could, or maybe you wanted them to.
What are you talking about, the score of the ball game?
The ball game.
You know, I think that's what happens to people. You know, our fans, when we sit down and look at the film, we analyze, we know what happens and the reason for it, and obviously, how in a football game when you only have 12 to 13 possessions in a ball game that you have to function offensively to be able to score points with some consistency. But when you make errors and penalties against a pretty good football team, then you're going to be punting the ball. We punted it 5 times with our possessions the other night, and a couple times we didn't score. We had one on fourth down or turned it over and didn't punt, which is worse. But defense played great. Defense controlled the ball game. You can see looking at this, you know, their quarterback looked like he made some yards. He made 50 yards in the ball game, 16 carries. So they averaged 3 yards per carry. We averaged over 6 yards a carry in the ball game, and that's what we've been averaging all year long. So it was something that wasn't a thing of beauty, but it was a win, and we could have played a lot better and probably scored a couple more. I don't think they would ever scored a touchdown on us. They hadn't in 3 years, and they got 2 field goals this time.
Well, it was an interesting football game, Coach. The OU sideline this week, the video portion at least, is, I think, appropriately named a song. It's by Elton John. Watch this week from the OU sideline.
Talk about a barrel full of punches. I'm out of bed and she don't.
Coach, you get ready now to go to Lawrence, Kansas, and the Kansas Jayhawks, and they've not had a lot of success.
They haven't played very well this year. I think that they lost this past weekend. They played Iowa State. Iowa State scored in the 40s on them. I think they scored 28 points. They lost to Colorado 35-10 the week prior to that. Of course, that's two teams we've already played, and I think that, you know, it'll be a ball game played there, but we'll have to play well as we did last year up there.
The team got stretched again. I mean, that's got to be, I think Jamel Holloway's comment pretty much says that, hey, it was a tough game, but yes, we did win it.
We won it, and that's what counts. We're 7-0 and headed north.
Headed north to Lawrence, Kansas. We'll see you next week on Oklahoma Football as we review the Kansas-Oklahoma game. We'll see you.
Oklahoma Football has been brought to you by Budweiser, Beechwood aged for that clean, crisp taste. This Bud's for you. And by USA West, America's best-tasting sports drink. Clothing for Barry Switzer and Steve Davis is provided by Harold's, Oklahoma City, Norman, and Tulsa.